Hi everyone, I am Tufan. Welcome to CMI's Digital Classrooms. Today, we will learn the next chapter of class 5, which is HCF and HCM. So first, let's discuss about HCF, that is highest common factor. So first, what highest common factor is? We already learn in class 4 about the introductions of HCF and LCM. So here, what the highest common factor is, let's see first with an example. Suppose there are three numbers given and it is asking to find out the highest common factor of those all numbers. So number are 24, 36, and 48. So these are the three numbers given and it is asking find the HCF of this number. Okay, so HCF of this number, this is the question. I will explain it with the example. Okay, if I give directly definition you might not understand, so first let's take an example, then we'll come to the definition. Okay, so 24, 36 and 48, these are the three numbers and these three numbers HCF you have to find out. Okay, so to find out the HCF of these all numbers, first we have to find the multiples of these all numbers. Okay, so let's find out 24. So what are the multiples of 24? Let's write with the 2. 12, 2, 6, 2, 3. That means 2 multiply 2 multiply 2 multiply 3. 24 is equal to this. Okay. Now please check 36. So 2 2 1 and 2, 8 2 are 16, 18, 2 are 36, 2, 9 2 are 18, 3, 3 3 are 9. So that means 36 is equal to 2 multiply 2 multiply 3 multiply 3. Let's check out 48. So 48, 2, 2 2 are 4, 4 2 are 8, 2 12, 2 6, 2 3. So 48 is equal to 14. So 2 multiply 2 multiply 2 multiply 2 multiply 3. So now we have found the multiples of this number. But we can say that factors, okay, so these are the factors of these all numbers. Okay, so factors of 24 are these, 36 are these and 48 are these. Now we will see which are the common factors of these all three numbers. So you can see 2 is the common here, again 1 more 2 is common here, but 1 more 2 is not here, but 3 is here, so 1 3 is common. The rest of all are not common, so these are the only common factors of these and these. Okay, so let's write common factor of these three numbers are, so of 24, 36, 48 are 2 multiply 2 multiply 3. That means 2 2 are 4, 4 3 are 12. 12. So 12 is the highest common factor of these three numbers. Actually, the common factors of these are 2, 2 and 3. Okay, so
2 × 2 × 3
is equal to 12. So 12 is the highest number which can be divided by this also, and this also. After 12, there is no any number which will be divide of all the three numbers. This is the highest number, not the lowest one. Okay. This is all about the highest common factor. That means we can conclude from this example that the highest common factor is, or highest common factor of a of two or more than two numbers is the numbers which is exactly divisible, which is exactly divide the all the three numbers. Okay, so if you talk about 12, 12 will be exactly divisible by all the three numbers, which is the greatest one or highest one. So the greatest number or the largest number which can be divide all the three, or two or more, whatever the number, it can be four number also. So as much as number, that all the numbers, that is called highest common factor. Okay. Now there is several method to find the highest common factor or HCF. So let's discuss 101. The first method which we will discuss is the finding HCF by prime factorization method. This is the method through which first we find out the factorization of the number, and then we find the HCF, as like we have done one example like same. So here one example I have taken, that is find the HCF of 9 and 18. If there is no any process written, I mean by which method you have to solve, you can use any method, but sometime in question directly it asks that find the HCF of this and this by prime factorization method, then you have to use the prime factorization method or whatever the method it is asking for. So here it is, there is no any question, in question it is not mentioned, so you can use any process, but here as we are discussing about prime factorization method, so let's solve this question using prime factorization method. So first we will find the factorization of these two numbers. Factorize 9 and 18. So first 9, 3, 3 and 9, 18, 2, 9 and 18, 3, 3 and 9. That means 9 is equal to 3 into 3, 18 is equal to 2 into 3 into 3. So these are the factors of 9 and 18. Now we have to check the common factor. Okay, so common factor, can you see only here 3, 1, 3 and then 2, 3. Okay, so 3 into 3. So common factor of 9 and 18 are 3 and 3. So 3 into 3 is equal to 9. So 9 will be the highest common factor of 9 and 18. Here you will write, therefore the HCF of this, so therefore HCF of 9 and 18 is 3 into 3 is equal to 9. So as the HCF of 9 and 18 is 3 into 3 is equal to 9. So this is how you can solve any, you can find out the HCF of any given number using factorization. If three numbers are given, you will check the common of all three numbers. If four is given, four same. Process will be same. So I hope you can do factorization method by yourself. Let's discuss one questions from exercise 3.1, which is find the LCM of 84, 105 and 168 by prime factorization method. So, to find out the LCM by prime factorization method, first we will find the factors of 84, 105 and 168. So, let's find the factors. Factors of 84, 105 and 168 are, let's find out for 84, 2, 4, 2 are 8, 2, 2 are 4, again 2, 2, 2 are 4, 2, 1 are 2, not 2, 3, 3, 7 are 21, okay, now for 105, so not 2, 3, 3, 3 are 9, 3, 5 are 15, 4, 5, 5, 5, 7 are 35, 168, 2, 8, 2 are 16, 4, 2 are 8, 2, 4, 2 are 8, 2, 2 are 4, 2, 2, 2 are 4, 2, 1 are 2, again 21, so 3, 7 are 21, so that means 84 is equal to 2 multiply 2 multiply 3 multiply 7, 105 is equal to 3 multiply 5 multiply 7, 168 is equal to 2 multiply 2 multiply 2 multiply 3 multiply 7. So these are the factors common. Now let's see which number are common among these all. 2 not here, gone, 2 gone. 3, 3 is here also, see, 3, 3, 3, and then 5 is not, 6, 7, 7, 7 is also common, here, here and here. So 3 and 7 are the number which are common about these two. So 3 and 7, therefore here you can write again that factors of these are 3 and 7, therefore HCF of 84, 105 and 168 is 3 into 7, 21. So, this is how you can find the HCF by prime factorization, but for the rest of all questions of exercise 3.1 by yourself. The next method is sort division method. Okay, so this is also nearby similar, but we used to find it all together. Okay, and this is usually used for the sort number. Sort number means smaller number, so that is why this is called a sort division method. Okay, but here you no need to do separately as like the previous prime factorization method. We will do all together. Okay, so let's do all together. Let's find out the LCF of 40, 64 and 80 by sort division method. So first let's write the numbers. 40, 64 and 8. Now let's say first which is the common factor for all the number, lowest common factor, I mean which is the smallest number through which we can divide all the numbers. Kaunsa aisa chota se chota number hai jisse sare number ko hum log divide kar sakte hain. So we will start from 2. Okay, so let's 2. Yes, 2 will be divisible for with all numbers. So 2, 20 are 40, then 2, 3 are 6, 2, 2 are 4, 32, 2, 4 are 8, 40. Again, you can see, you can divide by with the 2. So again, 2, 10 are 20, 16, 2 are 32, and
Shulil's shape, 5, 10, 5 to a 10, 8 to a 16, and 10 to a 20. So now, can you see, this is 5. So now you cannot divide by 2. Is all the, it should be divided by for with the all number. So 2, only these 2 will be divisible. This is not. So 2 will not take. 3 will not take. 4 will not take. 5 will also not be with this number. So after 5 there is this is the number, so definitely it will not be. So this much are the only numbers which can be multiple of or factors of this number. Now we will stop doing. So now you can see these are the numbers which don't have any common factor. So we'll, as we know that SCF means, SCF is the product of the common factors. SCF is the product of the common factor which is given. So here common, these three are the only common factor. So HCF of this is equal to HCF of 40, 64 and 80 are, but directly I am writing, so HCF is 2 into 2 into 2, 8. So this is how you can find the highest common factor of numbers given using sort division method. Okay, so I hope you can do the rest of all questions related to the sort division method which we have in 3.2. See, now next which we have is long division. Okay, so specially long division method we use for the longer number. Okay, so here I have taken 4-digit number to show you how can we do for longer number. I mean 4-digit number also together. It may be 2 digits also, it may be 3. I mean 2 numbers also, it may be 3 numbers also. So first try to understand what the long division method is. What we used to do in long division method. So for that, first thing which you should know is the divisor and dividend. Divisor is the number by which we are dividing, and dividend is the number which we are dividing. Okay, the larger number. So here first we have to check, suppose these two numbers, which one is the greater one. So this is the smaller, this is the greater one. So this number will divide by this, first thing. Okay, so greater number will be divided by the smaller number. This is the first step of long division method. After that, whatever the remainder we will get, that remainder again we will divide by that remainder to the, yes, to the dividend only. Okay, so dividend one again will come here, and that dividend we will divide by the remainder, and this process will continue until and unless you got zero as the reminder. So let's do one example, then you can understand properly. Okay, for example this one. So let's check, if in case of 2 or 3 number, first we will do for 2 number, and then we will find the SCF of those 2, and after finding the SCF of those 2, that SCF will do with the another one. Okay, so here 2 numbers, so 1260 and 1435. Let's do for these 2 number first. So first let's find out the SCF of these 2 numbers. So HCF of 1260 and 1435. So we will divide this by this. So 1260, 1435. Definitely. How many times it will goes? 1. Okay. So this 1 are 1260, because definitely 2 will be larger. So 6 to the 12, 7, 4, 1, 175, right?
175. Now this dividend, this will now come here as a divisor of this number. Okay, so 1260. Check how many times it will go. Okay, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 7 times. Check 1 7 times. So 7 5 5 2 12. Okay, so now again 5 3 35, right? So now again this will goes here. You don't need to show at the time of your classwork, otherwise most few of the students also used to use this sign. So don't use this sign here in your copy. Okay, I just shows you. So now this 175 will come here. So 175. So 35, how many times 175? 35 5 times. So 175. Now 0 comes. So and because now 0 comes, that means this one will be the HCF. Okay, this one will be the HCF of this number. The last divisor. The last divisor is the HCF of this number. Okay, so this is the last divisor. Therefore, HCF of these two numbers only. Okay, 1260 and 1435 is 35. Now, with the same process, we will find the HCF for this and this also. Okay, and after finding the HCF of this and this two number, whatever the HCF will come, that HCF and this HCF, again we need to find out the HCF of those two. Okay, now HCF of 1820 and 2170. So among these two, which one is greater? This one. This one is smaller. So 1820 will divide by 2170. How many times? One times only. So 18200 5. Okay. 350. Now this will come here. So 1820. Okay, how many times? 350. 350. 4. 5 times. 7. 0. 5. 17. So 0. 7. 70. 350. Okay, so how many times? 5 times. 35. So 70. That means 70 is the least divisor of this number. So 70 will be the HCF of this, and this is 70. So we got one HCF previously, another is here, this 70. Now we have to find out the HCF of these two, 70 and another one we got, which we got earlier, is 35. The earlier one is 35. Okay, so now you have to find HCF of 35 and 70 using the same process, and after finding whatever the HCF will come, that will be the answer. Okay, now exercise 3.1 and 3.2 are based on the highest common factor HCF. So 3.1 and 3.2 will be your homework. So do by yourself. If you found any doubts in solving any questions, you can ask. Thank you. Have a good time. Take care.